Welcome to my first screencast for class. This will take you through a sample literary analysis paragraph using the Tika Tika method. So whether or not you're familiar with it from Ms. Amager's class last year, or if you're new, this will be a good review. First of all, very simple. The T stands for topic sentence, but make sure that you use a transition word like first and foremost for the first body paragraph, or additionally, furthermore, above all for the other body paragraphs. And make sure it links to your thesis. This is all about the character and how their past really predicts their present. So make sure that's front and center in your topic sentence. You then introduce the quote. It's very important you set up this quote you chose. Who is saying this quote? Under what context? At what point in the novel? You can't just throw the reader into a quote. So that's key. Then, of course, you quote with a citation. And then you analyze the quote. Some students sometimes struggle with this because what they want to do is just give a summary or explain the literal meaning of the quote. Don't do that. Instead, you need to look at the language and structural choices the author made and help explain why those were effective choices, why they communicate effectively what the author was trying to say about the character and their past. And then you just repeat the same thing with a second quote, the only difference now that your second T is a transitional sentence to the second quote. Make sure you do also wrap up your paragraph. All of this is shown in my sample. So look at my topic sentence. Foremost in understanding author's present character is his PTSD as caused by his time serving during World War I. I used a transition. I know who the character is I will be talking about throughout the paragraph, and it's clear I'm connecting his past to his present. That's what a good topic sentence does. Notice what I've placed in red. Those are all the transition words. And you'll notice as I quickly scan through the paragraph right now, just how plentiful all of my transitions are. Transitions are not just for the beginning of a paragraph. They're also internal to help with flow and smooth progression. Everything in bold is words that I use instead of show. Oftentimes students rely too much on saying, this simile shows this. This symbol helps to show to the reader that. You wanna avoid that and make sure you're using good synonyms. You'll see plenty of samples throughout. Lastly, everything in yellow is my language analysis. Everything in blue is my structural analysis. So now I'm gonna skip ahead my intro to the quote and get to the analysis. So look at all the language analysis I made. The first quote I showed is told from Bernard as he explains how his dad really suffered PTSD when he came back from World War I, specifically because of the trench warfare. So I picked a quote that really resonates with that. I looked at the phrase battered gash. And then when you analyze a phrase like that, you have to ask yourself, why did Levi use that phrase? It's kind of odd. Because a gash is what you expect a human to suffer, an injury on an arm or a leg. But instead, the ground where the trenches were dug up is described as gash. Why does that work? Because it shows that the natural environment during World War I was harmed, just like a human would be, which then foreshadows what happened to Arthur psychologically. So I could explain all of that without summarizing what happened to him. I also go into the verb choices. They're all passive. Arthur did not return home triumphantly a hero. Instead, he was dropped off. He was delivered. So notice that the verbs do not have him making the actions. He has no agency. He is not independent. And on top of that, they objectify him. He is just an object. He is just a package to be delivered. And that very effectively shows what happened to him. I then transition to my second quote, so notice how I do that. Consequently, author's actions in World War II England become much more understandable when readers are made aware. I have my second quote, I analyze it for language again, the verbs and the oxymoron, and then I do structural analysis. This is different. You have probably not done this before. In the case of this novel, when it comes to structure, what we refer to is obviously the nonlinear chronology, it's told out of order, and the fact there's multiple narrators. In this case, it's important to know that the reader does not find out about Arthur's PTSD until later in the book. So in the Gilbert quote, we think he's just crazy, but then getting Bernard's narration really helps flesh this out. And that's why Andrea Levy's nonlinear choices are so important. And then I wrap it up. This is what I expect this year, and I hope that this proves